physical features of India. Now we are going to learn about physical features of India. First we will see that location and size, then physical features. After that we will see how the mountains of India are. Now our India, the Indian subcontinent is cut off from the rest of Asia by the Himalayas in the north, Hindu Kush in the west, and the Arakan Yoma in the east. Arabian Sea lies in the southwest and the Bay of Bengal in the southeast. Now we are having this sea by the three sides of our map. You can see Arabian Sea, then Indian Ocean and Bay of Bengal. Indian Ocean lies in the south and Kanyakumari forms the southern tips of the Indian Peninsula. And our physical features of India divided into six main divisions: Northern Mountains, Northern Plains, Great Indian Deserts, Peninsula Plateau, Coastal Plains and Island Groups. Northern Mountains are divided into three parts: Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik. Himadri is the highest and longest range from the extreme northern part. Then Himachal Mountains lie between the Shivalik Mountains in the south and the Himadri Mountains in the north. And the Shivalik Mountains lying south of the Himachal region, and it is the youngest one. Now we'll read about Northern Plains. Northern Plains, we are having four divisions of the Great Plains: Barber Belt at the foothills, then Terai Belt lying to the next, and Bangar Belt comprising older alluvium forms. Another thing we are having in India, Great Indian Desert. The first, which one is the biggest desert in our India? The Thar Desert lies in the northwestern part of India, and it is the seventh largest desert in the world and is mainly situated in Rajasthan, covering a little more than a half of its area. Now we'll learn about Peninsula Plateau. Peninsula Plateau lies to the south of the Ganga Basin. It is the oldest landmass of India and is made up of hard, igneous and metamorphic rocks. Then Narmada River and the Vindhya and Satarupa ranges divide this region into Malwa Plateau in the north and Deccan Plateau in the south. Now what is there between this Narmada River and the Vindhya and Satarupa ranges? It is divided into Malwa Plateau 1 and northern Deccan Plateau in the south. Malwa Plateau is in the north and Deccan Plateau is in the south. Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri are eastward flowing rivers in the Deccan. These are the seasonal rivers. Seasonal rivers means in the rainy season it is having water and other season it becomes dry. Tapti River is an important westward flowing river that flows across a rift valley. Anamudi, the highest peak in the South India, is located in the Western Ghat. The eastern edge of the plateau is called Eastern Ghat and it is the low and discontinuous hill. Eastern Ghat and Western Ghat cover is at Nilgiris.